Welcome to Quarantine Kitchen.
Hello. Good morning.
Good morning. This is episode 23, and it is our second installment of Quarantine Kitchen International. We have our own Quarantine Kitchen in Halle, Germany, and we have a special guest chef in the Quarantine Kitchen today. Her name is Bella, and she's coming to us from Phoenix, Arizona.
Hi, Bella.
Hey, Bella. How you doing? Tonya, you saw Bella's video. What'd you think?
It was cute.
It was really cute, wasn't it?
Yep, you did very well. In this life, in this life,
in this life, in this life, in this life, in this so sweet life. Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to make an acai bowl, but before I do, I wanted to introduce myself. My name is Bella, and I live in Phoenix, Arizona. We're typically known for being crazy hot, but it's actually kind of nice here, and people are surprisingly very outdoorsy. During the winter, it's a great place to hike, and during the spring, everything turns really green with the cactus and all the desert flowers. But that's why an acai bowl is perfect for this place, because you need a cool treat to help you in the hot summers. Make an acai bowl. It's super easy, not that many steps. First, you're gonna want frozen fruit. Obviously, you're gonna need acai packets, and then I like to use banana, strawberry, and blueberry, but you can kind of pick whatever fruit you like. Most of these you can just find at a grocery store in the frozen aisle in different baggies or packets. That's what I do, at least. And then also, you're gonna need a liquid. I'm using cashew milk, but you can use like apple juice, regular milk, almond milk, kind of whatever you think would taste good together. And that's all you really need for the base, but I like to add coconut peanut butter in it as well, or just regular peanut butter too, just to give it extra protein and like a fun little extra taste. Why do you look so sad? And forsaken, diddly bong. When one door is closed, don't you know? For the ingredients, you just need a blender. And then you're just gonna put your liquid in there. Alrighty. And how much you put in is kind of up to you. If you want it to be thicker, put less. If you want it to be like thinner, more like smoothie like, you can put more, but put it up to you. You're gonna put your frozen fruit in. Bowl to put it into, and then also the toppings you want. I like to put granola on top and bottom, and then I like to add some fresh fruit. So I have strawberries and blueberries, then also a banana that I'll cut and put on top. And then sometimes I like to add macadamia nuts and cacao nibs. But whatever you put on top is totally up to you. You can do any fruits or seeds or nuts, just kind of whatever sounds good. Alrighty, so first I'm gonna put down some granola. Alright, and then I'm gonna get my spatula. I'm just gonna take out all the acai from the blender. Thank you. sponge on it all out, so I'm just gonna kind of smooth it out in the bowl. All right, and so then I'm gonna put marginola on top. Up, I have my banana, and then I have my strawberries and blueberries. Just cutting that. And then I wash my hands before this, so don't worry. Kind of lay that across like that. Get my fruit, sprinkle that across. And then I said this earlier, but you don't have to do the same fruits. You can kind of add whatever you want. If you want like kiwis or pineapple or flaxseed, or sometimes like even get crazy, put some chocolate sauce on it. Why not, right? So now I have my fruit on, and then I have my macadamia nuts and my cacao nibs. I'm just gonna sprinkle those on as well. Alrighty, and then now you're done. It's all topped and you're set to eat it. Oh, please, don't you rock my boat. No, no, cause I don't want my boat to be rocking. I'm telling you that, oh, 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 I like it like this. Alrighty, now that I have the acai bowl all done and made, I wanted to talk a little bit about acai and the other ingredients I had in it, and just where they come from and what their health benefits are. So acai comes from Central and South America in like more tropical climates, and so you can't find it anywhere here in its natural berry form, but you can buy it in frozen, powder, or like juice forms. But they're super nutrient dense and packed with antioxidants that have lots of health benefits to them.
Pudding tonight. I am going to go over the ingredients with you really quick. We've got some unsweetened almond milk that we're going to use, a little bit of cinnamon, some vanilla, some maple syrup, and some chia seeds. So the recipe is for one serving or a small serving. I'm going to actually double it because we're going to use this in a different recipe tomorrow. So we've got 2 cups of almond milk here. We're going to pour this in a bowl, and then we are going to use 1/2 cup of chia seeds. I'm just going to use this 1/4 cup here. So 1/2 cup of chia seeds. 2 cups of the almond milk. We're gonna do 2 teaspoons of vanilla. This is homemade vanilla also, by the way. And 2. Okay, and then it calls for 2 teaspoons of syrup. I'm gonna put in 4 teaspoons. So there's 1, 2, 3, and we're just gonna put just a little sprinkle of cinnamon on top. So with this, you just whisk it together. We're going to just put this into a container and stick it in the refrigerator, and in a couple of hours it will gel together and thicken. So by tomorrow it'll be ready for our other recipe that we're making for our next video. So that's it, very easy.
So today's episode, we're kind of focusing on superfoods. Bella chose as her recipe to make a berry bowl out of acai berries.
Yeah.
Or is it acai?
Acai.
Acai berries. Okay, so we had to learn a little bit something about the acai berry, yeah?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Turns out that they are considered a superfood.
Mm-hmm.
One of the reasons that they're a superfood is that they're very high in fiber. They're very low in fat.
Mm-hmm.
They're supposedly great for your brain functions.
Okay.
Which
we need.
Yeah, for sure. They raise your good cholesterol levels,
mm-hmm,
in your blood. They lower your bad cholesterol levels. Also, they have some antioxidant effect to help stave off cancer.
Mm-hmm.
So they're really considered a superfood, and there's a lot of power in those acai berries.
Yeah.
So that was a very healthy bowl that Bella
created.
Bella created.
Yeah.
So that was interesting.
Mm-hmm.
So tell us a little bit about the ingredients
so
there.
So we're going to add the powder, the acai powder, because we can't, you know, get the frozen acai berries. So we're going to use powder.
Mm. Let me taste that.
Okay.
Let me see what that tastes like. See, I got a little. Mmm. It's really tart. So that's going to add some tartness to whatever we've got going.
Uh-huh.
But you can really get the berries. It's that's really nice. I like it.
Okay. So we'll blend the powder with the berries, the frozen berries, and we've got a mixture of frozen raspberries, strawberries, blueberries, and Johannes beer in German. I don't know what it is in English.
I'll figure that out and I'll put that on the video.
Yeah. We don't have those, like, we don't see those in the store, but they're these little tiny berries like this. They almost look like a tiny cherry.
Cherry,
like
cranberry. But they're not.
No.
I'll look up what Johannes beer is in
English. I thought
it was
gooseberry, but maybe not.
It could be gooseberry, but I don't think so, but we'll check it out.
Okay.
So we've got the mystery berry with blueberries, strawberries, and raspberries.
Right.
So this is just frozen from the from the case, okay?
And then we've got fresh strawberry sliced and fresh banana.
Yep.
And then some fresh pineapple.
Fresh pineapple cut
this morning. We're gonna use the almond milk for blending.
Yep.
And then we're also gonna put in our bowl, we're gonna put in some chia pudding, which I've already made.
Right, you made that last night and we showed that video.
So,
So the chia seeds is our twist on this.
Uh-huh.
So the chia seeds are also considered a superfood. The benefits of the chia seeds are that they're very, very high in fiber.
Mm-hmm.
They are very, all of their carbohydrates come in the form of fiber, so that they have net zero carbs, so it has no effect on blood sugar.
Okay, great.
So this chia pudding would actually be a pretty good option for a diabetic, for breakfast. Also, the chia seeds are very dense in omega-3 fatty acids, which are also good for the heart.
Yeah.
So the bowl you're making is kind of, I guess I would call it a super bowl.
Yeah, okay.
Double superfoods.
Yeah.
And, you know, the double the the health benefits.
Right. And we're gonna top, Bella used some granola, so we're gonna put in some granola as
right,
well.
For some texture, yeah. Right?
So we're gonna just blend the berries now and create the base, and then we'll add the rest of our ingredients.
Perfect, all right, we'll be right back. Put on a spoon, let's give it a taste. Okay. Mm. Yeah, okay. It's a berry smoothie right now.
Okay.
Fortified with acai.
Berries first in the bowl.
Okay.
So it's just kind of like really smoothie,
here, let's
like,
get this out of the way.
Almost like an ice cream consistency, right?
Yeah, it is. It's like a sherbet right now.
Yeah.
Berry sherbet. It's delicious. Okay, so you got your berry base.
Uh-huh. So we're going to put in our chia pudding.
Okay.
And just sit this. I don't have a pretty glass bowl to show what it would look like layered, so I'm just going to
do four,
this.
So four tablespoons of five?
I mean, it doesn't matter.
You're just going to cover. Are you making these individual?
Yeah.
So each one of us is going to get a bowl like this.
Yeah.
Okay. So you're going to spread that.
Mm-hmm. That's fine. I mean, it doesn't need to be perfect, right?
Right.
Okay. So then we're going to add in the granola, I think.
Okay. Give it a little crunch, a little texture.
I can add a lot of granola. I don't have very much to add anyway. So then we're gonna put in some strawberries here. And some bananas over here. And then we'll put in some pineapple.
I should have cut up some kiwi. Some green would have been really pretty on that. So that looks pretty good.
Yeah.
Can't wait to try it. All right.
So
there's one. All right, there's one. Okay, so we're back. We've got the bowls completely done. Tanya just thought of an interesting finish. What do you got there, Tanya?
A little bit of coconut flakes.
Okay.
Yeah. So I thought we'd just put a little coconut on the very middle there, just for kind of a garnish.
Is this sweetened coconut or unsweetened?
No, it's unsweetened.
Okay. But there's plenty of sweetness from all the fruit
right.
in that bowl.
Yeah. Yeah. So there you go.
All right. You could even finish that with a sprinkling of some more chia seeds if you wanted to, but we're not gonna do that. We don't have the chia seeds out. But those look pretty dang good. What do you think, Bella? We are saying goodbye from the quarantine kitchen.
Bye.
I always give you a chance to make a shout out, Tanya, if you wanna say hello to
hello,
anybody.
Hello, everyone.
Just hello to everybody.
Hello, everybody.
Hello, everybody. Yes. We hope you're all healthy and take care of yourselves.
Yep,
it's,
for sure.
That's more important than ever.
Absolutely.
Yep. So, so long from the quarantine kitchen.
Bye.
And we'll see you next time. Tschüss. Tonya, how was that Açaí Chia Berry Bowl?
It was pretty good.
It was pretty good. I felt I really got a boost today. My vitamins, my minerals. It was Bella in Phoenix, and thank her for playing in the quarantine kitchen with us.
Mm-hmm, yeah,
it was
fun.
It was a nice recipe.
Yeah, it was easy, which is nice.
Yeah, a no-cook recipe, right. It's just something you could whip up and even put it in the refrigerator the night before.
Right.
I'm curious what we're going to do with the rest of that acai powder. We got quite a bit.
Yeah, well, we can use it like on smoothies and even sprinkle it like on fruit or something like that.
Yeah.
You know, we can look up recipes. I'm sure there's recipes that we can use it to make things.
Yeah, that would be good. I think we should...
Make some ice cream.
Yeah,
blend up some berries.
That might be good. That might be good. There were no real problems making it. There was no real problems. The main challenge for us was finding the
berries,
the acai berries. But did you get it from a website or did you go to Amazon? Or?
The powder I bought from Amazon DE.
So we got 1.1 pounds, 500 grams for $15.90.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a bunch left.
Oh yeah, for sure. Yeah.
So the weather's beautiful here in Hala. Today the sun is shining bright. What would you say the temperature is? About 72, 73?
No, it's like 65.
Is that cold?
Yeah, it's 65.
That must be the California boy still in me. 65 seems cold, but I'm in short sleeves. It feels comfortable.
Yeah.
Last chance to say a shout out to anybody out there in.
Why don't you say a shout out to somebody?
Me?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're always telling me, you don't want you to do it.
All right, well, I'd like to give a shout out to the next two guest quarantine chefs that we have lined up.
Mm-hmm.
We've got the videotape, the footage, and the stills. Mm-hmm. We're going to put these next two episodes into production. Just to give you a little a preview of coming attractions, we've got Kara in Encinitas, California, and she's making some kind of a savory creme brulee.
Mm-hmm. And it's Kara, not Cara.
What did I say?
You always call her Cara.
Cara, Kara. But what did I just say right now?
She goes by Kara. You said Kara. You said it right this time.
So why correct me in front of the whole planet?
Because I want Kara to make sure she chips into the conversation and corrects you from if it's Cara or if it's Kara. I think it's Kara from class and from... I think even when she introduced herself, when I heard her video, it was Kara. But you always
now you just
Cara.
Said Kira.
I said Kara.
I say Cara. It sounds
anyway.
It sounds a little more European. So we have a video though from Kara in Encinitas coming up, a savory creme brulee, and then we also have our friend Alex from Ontario, California, and he's gonna share with us a special margarita recipe, and I believe he roasted a chicken on a smoker.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to say that there's one other side dish coming with it. So anyway, please, if you find this video, if you find this content entertaining, first off, like it. Second, subscribe. Third, share it. And number four, leave a comment. This channel can only grow with your support. We are really pushing to get some subscribers over the next few weeks. Mm-hmm. If anybody out there is interested in being a guest chef on the Quarantine Kitchen, please contact us. Our email's in the video. Our Facebook page address is in this video. Our YouTube channel. If you're watching this, you're probably on YouTube. So contact us. We're interested in chefs from from everywhere.
Everywhere.
Yeah. All corners of the globe.
Yeah, and we'll do our best to try to make up a recipe.
Yeah.
Yeah, depending on what kind of ingredients we can find.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, if we can get the ingredients, we'll make it and we'll probably put our own twist on it.
Yeah.
So I think with that, that's all I've got from the quarantine terrace.
Yeah.
What do you got, Tonya? Anything else?
That's it. Just that there's lots of bees around. So if you see me looking around, it's because there's bees buzzing over my head.
And the murder bees haven't made their appearance yet.
I don't know.
We're just wondering what else is going to happen. We're hearing about murder bees and all kinds of craziness out there. So be careful. Mm-hmm. Stay away from the murder bees.
Yeah. And stay away from the virus.
Stay away. Stay clear from the virus. Keep yourselves busy. Keep fit. Exercise. And do what we all need to do. Stay indoors until we're allowed to go outdoors. All right. So see you later from the quarantine kitchen.
Bye.
Bye.